चॉकलेट पीनट बटर कुकीज़ डिप्ड इन कैरमल सॉस, इट डजंट गेट बेटर देन दिस। Hi everyone and welcome to Sugar Spice Nice. My name is Shweta and in this video I'm sharing with you chocolate peanut butter cookies. I've been really loving indulging in these, especially on days when it's a little bit cloudy or it's raining, and I have these cookies and some hot chocolate or some tea on the side, and it's just such a blissful, comforting combination. So I thought to myself, why enjoy them alone, and might as well share it with you guys. And these are really simple to make. I've even switched up with a few toppings, including one really easy and really delicious basic caramel sauce, which in my opinion is one of the best things that you can dip this cookie into and have. Like, I'm salivating right now while talking about it. So without further ado, let me straight take you to my kitchen and show you how I made them. But I must tell you that I'm not going to be using any eggs or oven in making this. We're going to be making it in a frying pan. So let's head to the kitchen and start making these cookies. I'm making these cookies with chocolate, but if you prefer plain ones, then just skip the cocoa powder altogether. Either way, you're gonna need some peanut butter. I'm using the crunchy peanut butter from As It Is Nutrition, and their peanut butter is sugar free, and you can see here it's so beautifully thick and luscious. Peanut butter is a great source of protein for vegetarians, and it honestly tastes yummy on a toast, in cakes, cookies, and even salads. I'm gonna leave a link to the As It Is peanut butter in the description box below, so do check it out. And here in this recipe, I'm using about half a cup. Then we have a quarter cup of cocoa powder, a spoon of vanilla extract, a heaped tablespoon of regular butter, 1.5 cup of whole wheat flour, half a cup of powdered sugar, and a teaspoon of baking soda, and 3/4 cup of milk. So these are all the ingredients ready. You can even replace the whole wheat flour with maida, but I just wanted to make my cookies with whole wheat flour. So first I'm throwing in the butter, and then I'm adding sugar to it, and then I'm mixing these two. At this point, it helps if the butter is a little softened already. So, you know, just take it out from the fridge and keep it. And this is just regular butter. If you have unsalted butter, then use that if you like. And if you don't want to use butter, then you can even use ghee. And you have to stir this in till it's combined. And then add the peanut butter in. Peanut butter needs to be mixed well, and you can see how beautiful and creamy this looks, and I'm honestly loving how this is feeling right now. And the aroma of peanut butter takes over. I personally love it. Now this is mixed nicely, and I'm adding the vanilla extract and mixing it in. And then goes the flour and the cocoa powder. I'm also adding the baking soda at this point. Now this is going to be a task to mix, because I've used a very small mixing bowl, but you guys don't do that. Try and use a bigger bowl to avoid all of these spills. So I'm just trying my best to mix and spill as little as possible. And once you mix it a little bit, it's time to add the milk. So what I'm doing is adding the milk little by little, but if you have a bigger bowl, then just add it all in one go. And once the milk is added, just keep mixing this. And this is difficult, but I'm trying my level best to mix it in well. So I'm going to fast forward this mixing process, and I honestly wish it was this simple in real life as well. Now the ingredients are mostly combined, and finally I do this. I go in with my hands and just knead the dough a little bit, like how you do for regular atta. And here you can see the dough is ready, and there are those little peanut chunks as well, which do feel very, very good once you're having the cookies. Now this goes in the fridge for about 20 minutes, and in the meantime I'll preheat the pan. So this is a non-stick pan, and I'm brushing it with oil very generously, and then I'm using a food wrapping paper and lining it. Now you actually need to use a butter paper or parchment paper here, but I don't have that, so I'm just using this. And then I'm putting the lid of the pan on and letting this heat up on a low flame for about 15 minutes. Now the cookies can be rolled into these balls and flattened slightly. And I'm not making these too big. These are mid-sized cookies, and that is because I want them to get cooked evenly since we're making them in a pan. And then we just place them in the pan like this. I'm also topping them with some chocolate chunks. This is just chopped up dark chocolate. And you can use whatever chocolate you like, or even chocolate chips, because that is the one that they use mostly in cookies. And if you don't like it, then you can just skip adding any chocolate at this point. Now these get ready in about 20 to 25 minutes on a low flame. So now these are ready and they've actually turned out pretty amazing. These are not like the very hard crunchy cookies. They're more like the little soft, slightly moist ones. Actually not moist, they're just not like, you know, crunchy. And the chunk of chocolate in the middle is amazing. You can definitely feel free to add more chocolate bits. And I also like the little bits of peanut from the crunchy peanut butter in this. So here I'm just gonna break this and show you how it looks. And it's officially time to have the first bite. These have turned out really nice. And I personally love cookies that are more softer. I could have added a bit more sugar. And I also should have added a few more chocolate chunks. And peanut butter definitely brings a lot of goodness to cookies. You can feel that slight flavor. The dough becomes that much more creamy, and that definitely reflects really well on the cookies. Now these are literally the exact same cookies. I made them the exact same way, but I rolled them like even more tinier, almost like mini cookies. Then I added some jam to the center. This is mixed fruit jam, and also a little bit of the peanut butter, and cook them in a pan like I showed you before. Honestly, I like this size of cookies. It just ensures that you're not eating too much at a time, because while eating cookies, it's really, really difficult to like stop. Let me know in the comments if you guys also feel the same way about cookies. This is feeling like a different version of Jim Jam biscuits, but an even better version of Jim Jam, if I can say so. And I love jam, like even jam bread and stuff I absolutely love. And peanut butter and jam together is what a combination. And this little jam filling in the center is just amping up the cookie. And if you like jam, then I definitely recommend like doing the topping like this, because this feels amazing. And goes without saying, you can add any jam, any flavor that you like. I love mixed fruit, strawberry, raspberry. Let me know your favorite jam flavors in the comments below. I also tried to make these caramel filled ones, but honestly, they didn't turn out as I expected. But nonetheless, they taste delicious. So for the caramel, I melted some sugar, and this can take a while, and you have to actually keep stirring it until all the sugar crystals and lumps melt off. And you can get this beautiful brownish sugar syrup. To that, add a generous chunk of butter, and again mix it in until the butter melts, and then add a tablespoon of cream. This is just regular ghar ki malai. And again, mix it and also add some salt. So this caramel mix, I added in between the cookies. So first I flattened one, then I added the caramel sauce, and then covered it with another flattened cookie layer. And it was a bigger cookie. And I basically cooked this in the exact same way in a pan. Now this cookie turned out to be quite big, so I just broke a few bits. It actually tastes really good. It's the exact same dough, so the caramel is making it just perfectly sweet. Now normally when you are buying caramel cookies from the market, you can see that caramel layer when you're breaking the cookie and all, and that didn't happen with my cookie. And it is looking moist, but the caramel has kind of lost its color. It's become brown with, you know, the heat and everything. But even then, it's not feeling burnt, it's not feeling weird, it's feeling good. You can feel that, you know, caramelly flavor. I think these would honestly be perfect if I just bring the caramel sauce from my kitchen, dip each bite into them and enjoy them. So I went into my kitchen, got myself the caramel sauce and another cookie, and oh good God. This is the best. Cannot stop licking my fingers. I think you should try making these and make sure you dip them in the caramel sauce really nice and enjoy them. It just tastes so amazing. And let me know in the comments below how you enjoyed it. And if you'd like to see more recipes with peanut butter, then let me know that as well. And I'm going to leave a link to the as it is crunchy peanut butter in the description bar below. So make sure you check that in case you're looking for a good, creamy, delicious peanut butter option. And that is really it from me. Make sure you give this video a big like, share it with your friends and family, subscribe to my channel for more, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.